Vittorio De Sica's Marriage Italian Style follows the decades-long relationship between a prostitute-turned-mistress, Filomena Marchionne, played by Sophia Loren, and businessman Domenico Soriano, played by Marcello Mastroianni. This film is based off the successful play Filomena Marchionne and was nominated for Best Foreign Language Film at the 1966 Academy Awards. De Sica joins the likes of Pietro Germi and Ettore Scola and uses tropes of the Commedia Italiana to comment on society.
Che non ha nascosto i temi più gravi, non ha nascosto i problemi, però visti con ironia, con leggerezza. A parte che come film hanno avuto successo anche come informazioni su un paese.
So what information about Italy is De Sica trying to highlight in Marriage Italian Style? De Sica specifically employs this genre to highlight structures of gender, marriage.
Mi dichiaro marito e moglie.
Patriarchy.
Fuori dalla casa mia! Fuori tu!
And family. The character of Filomena, which Sophia Loren won Best Actress in a Foreign Film for playing, exhibits the trope of the commanding woman whose physicality and economic dominance are emphasized in showing her ability to navigate the existing societal structures. Filomena and the successful businessman first meet at a brothel during World War II. As a woman and a sex worker, Filomena does not yet have economic dominance. Women in Italy were not allowed to vote until a year after the war, when perspectives on a woman's role in society were changing. 2 years later, 40 women were voted into parliament and used their status to propel the women's rights forward. However, the Italian government, led by the Christian Democrats, remained patriarchal, and women were still largely seen as inferior to men. Prostitutes were legally second-class citizens. During the fascist era, brothels were state-sanctioned and sex workers were heavily policed and essentially detained in the brothel. The money the woman made was taken by the owner of the business or by the government for taxing purposes. Filomena's social status almost guarantees an arduous life. However, she uses her sexuality to attract Domenico, who uses her for nothing more than her physicality. Over the years, she becomes his frequent sexual companion and confidant. She is not content in this role, and more than once pushes for more out of the relationship. Domenico begrudgingly placates these requests, first by moving her out of her brothel into an apartment and later into his mother's house. These accommodations are not what they seem. The former owner of the apartment had died and she has moved into his mother's house to take care of the ailing woman.
Hey.
Over time, she comes to terms with the reality of the relationship, putting aside feelings of love, as more and more she is acting like a partner in marriage without the legal or emotional security of marriage. She lives in his house, cares for his mother, and helps run his business despite her lack of formal schooling. Her dubious status as Domenico's woman, but not his wife, indicates an idea about the role of women and their responsibilities to family, whether or not they are married. Responsibilities which, as a man, Domenico does not share.
Ma dove vai? C'è la macchina qui.
Sei stato fuori 4 mesi. Torni e mi parli di scarpe.
It is Domenico's indifference to her and ongoing relationships with other women which push her to the extreme of faking illness in order to secure a marriage, which she successfully accomplishes. Domenico is embarrassed that he was duped by a woman of her status.
Cretino! Cretino! Sei un cretino effetente!
In one final attempt to keep him, Filomena reveals her motive behind marrying Domenico. She wants to secure a last name for her 3 children, one of whom is Domenico's. Now the roles are reversed and Filomena can give Domenico what he wants, fatherhood. In the scene where Domenico discovers her ploy, De Sica shows that Filomena is the one with power. She has power over Domenico and over the house staff.
Dove stanno?
Stanno conservati.
Brava, vai.
She seems to come into her power and shed the label of second-class citizen, and the audience realizes that from that point on, she is in control.
Presso a quella schifoso, un uomo di 50 anni con una ragazza di 20.
Ma che ti importa a te se quella tiene 20 o 22 anni?
Niente, niente, niente. Di te non mi importa più niente. Tu adesso mi servi e basta.
Driven by ego, Domenico frantically tries to figure out which is his true heir, but is ultimately unsuccessful. He yearns to know which boy is his, but Filomena does not tell him out of fear that Domenico will only support that child. She is not the traditional mother, but she wants all three boys to be treated the same, as illegitimate children were also legally second-class citizens. Domenico finally gives in, and the two reconcile. After decades of hardship and strife, the two are wed, with all of her sons inheriting the Soriano name.
Domani vi chiamerete col mio stesso nome, Soriano.
In this film, De Sica makes commentary about the roles of women living in the Italian patriarchy, in particular, sex workers and mothers. Despite Filomena's status as a poor, uneducated sex worker, she is eventually able to navigate the world of the upper class and get what she wants. She is clever and admired by others. Although relegated to a second-class treatment, she is shown fighting for the life she wants and for a better life for her children. She may not be a traditional mother or woman, or have a traditional family, but she is strong and was determined to give her kids a better life than she herself had.
No.